tonight's game, Jack D, ready for all the action.
And now let's take a look at the starting lineups. The little long tails and the orange collars made it all the way to the championship game last season, only to be outmatched by the Pouncy Panthers. This year, they head into playoffs with one of the most dynamic offenses in the league, starring the roly-poly, unstoppable running cat, it's Marbles. On defense, the Longtails' formidable Christmas trio leaves opponents shaking in their stockings. Leading them on the gridiron, it's Jingle.
Starting for the always powerful Last Hope Lions, playing in the red collars, that wide receiver, the Royal One, dazzles with cuteness and speed. It's Prince Harry II. At running cap, always helping his team out of a jam, it's Huckleberry. And on defense, he's Large. He's in charge. Sarge.
And now the moment we've all been waiting for. Playoff game number one of Kitten Bowl 6.
Ooh, here we go, baby.
All right, let's have fun, partner.
A little long tail's taking a field. Last Hope Lions looking a little nervous right now. Mr. McWiggle's taking position.
And there's the kickoff. And the little Longtails leaping into action. But the Lions are just lying around. Longtails really going after the ball now. And Mr. McWiggles almost gets a paw on it. And Marbles receives the kickoff.
The little Longtails are really high-fiving it out. Wow, Dean. They're really excited about it. How many high fives was that anyway? Let's take a look. Seven high fives?
Wow, that's got to be a Kitten Bowl record.
as a vet of big games, I think it's a little early for the high five. But hey, I'm glad the long tails came to play.
They sure did. Mr. McWiggles with the ball, looking for a play here. All alone. He decides to run the ball himself. And stopped by his own teammate, Jingle. Apparently, he was running the wrong way down the field.
Well, the little Longtails are really fired up today, Dean. They keep this energy up. They just might take it all the way to the championship.
So true. Especially with Huckleberry from the Lions just sitting there, dreaming about who might be adopting him and what his new home might be like.
And if Prince Harry II doesn't start playing some defense, the Last Hope Lions will be coming in last.
It's third down for the little Longtails. And it's a long bomb downfield. Caught by Mr. McWiggles. Oh, it's a fumble. Recovered by Prince Harry II.
Well, Prince Harry II finally decided to get in the game.
He spots his teammate downfield. And Prince Harry II fires off a long bomb of his own. This could be a huge turnaround for the Last Hope Lions. Marbles has an eye on it. And it's intercepted by Marbles. And run back for a touchdown. What a turn of events.
Incredible. As you can see in the Subaru slow motion kitten cam, Marbles rolls on into the end zone.
Tank barrels up for the extra point. It's good. Making the score Little Longtail 7, Last Hope Lions 0. Well, that Marbles is quite a player, Rodney. Let's learn a little bit more about him. Many think Marbles got his name for his marbled-looking coat, but he was actually found hiding in a box full of marbles at a toy store. When he got strong, he was drafted by the Last Hope Lions until he became a free agent, and the Lions lost their marbles to the Little Longtails. Now, a first-string running cat for the Longtails, Marbles' temper sometimes spins out of control, which often gets him in trouble during games. If he can avoid penalties, Marbles might just shoot to feline football stardom. And besides, he's really cute.
Great story. Meanwhile, back on the field, Marbles and the little Longtails are still doing victory laps after that last big score.
And the Last Hope Lions are set to receive. Tulip tiptoes into position. Prince Harry II looking like he's ready for a stately nap, as usual. Huckleberry still daydreaming about his new home. There's a kickoff. Dash dashes in and receives the kickoff. What? No, no, he doesn't. Wait a minute. Yes, he does. No. No, he fumbles. The long tails and the Lions both racing in. And, oh, it's another touchdown for the little long tails. What a play by Pepper. And the crowd goes crazy.
I tell you what, Dean. These Last Hope Lions better get their act together because the little long tails are running circles around them. As you can see.
And the extra point is up by Jet, and it's good. Making the score Little Long Tails 14, Last Hope Lions 0.
These Lions really need to find their growl again, Dean, if they want to stay in this game.
There's Cash with a big play and a pass. Both teams racing in. The Sarge has it, and he is Union Jack short of the goal line by his own teammate, Prince Harry II.
Mr. McWiggles jumping for joy after that play. Prince Harry II not feeling so great right now.
You know, Prince Harry II may not be the best catleet out there on the field today, but his cuteness scores are off the chart.
Tell us more about this royal one.
More precious than a crown of jewels, meet the Last Hope Lions tiniest player. It's the royal Prince Harry II. Harry once lived in a castle and was groomed to live a posh life. But he always had dreams of playing in the Feline Football League. So he said cheerio to merry old England and headed to the Last Hope Lions tryouts. At first, Prince Harry II thought he could get by with just his royal cuteness. But he had some trouble keeping up with some of the bigger catleets. He worked hard, and the Lions coach, Pharaoh, gave him a spot on the team. Now this little prince hopes he's next in line to win a championship trophy and reign over the gridiron.
Well, as cute as he may be, Prince Harry II and his Last Hope Lions, the great cats with the red collars and the feathers in their mouth, are tailing the little long tail, the black and white cats with the orange collars, by 14 points. Mm. Let's see if these Lions can claw their way back for a shot at the Cotton Bowl championship.
The Lions have the ball. Looks like Prince Harry II is finally getting off of his royal caboose. And Cash looking for a move here. He bombs it all the way downfield.
The long tail's defense seems perplexed.
It's going. It's going. It's going. And Huckleberry runs it in for a touchdown.
Unbelievable play, Dean.
Huckleberry is something. And Cooper leaps onto the uprights. And the extra point at the whistle. Making the score Little Long Tails 14, Last Hope Lions 7. And it looks like the Lions finally got their growl back, Rodney.
That's right. Sarge is over there showing Mr. McWiggles who's in command. Well, Dean, that was some amazing FFL playing we just saw. And there's more of that coming right up. Plus, Gino, the Hero Cat.
But first, let's go down to a very special guest who will be joining us all day. The ambassador of Hallmark Channel's Adoption Ever After campaign, Rebecca Romaine.
Thanks, Dean. I'm so excited to be the ambassador of Hallmark Channel's Adoption Ever After campaign. Our mission is